My dear friends, from the book of Isaiah chapter 2, verse 2 onwards we read, on that day, God will raise up a mountain and the Lord's temple will be built up on that mountain. Mountain symbolizes the divine presence in which God wants to be there and rule his people. There are many places where in the Old Testament God speaks about his presence in the temple. Isaiah speaks about Jesus' birth connecting with the mountain. We may be wondering why Isaiah should speak about the birth of Jesus with the mountain. He says, on that mountain, God will establish his presence. And let's go to the temple of the Lord, to that mountain, and meet him. He is our King. He is our God. When we look into the Old Testament, especially, we see in the book of Genesis chapter 12, when God said to Abraham, leave your home and go to the land which I show to you. So Abraham with his wife Sarah and with his cattle and so on, they are traveling. He was working in the field. Now suddenly he finds a mountain. He did not know how to climb on the mountain. He is not used to. So what did he do? And the lower part of the mountain called Moreh, he offers an offering and says, Lord, may your presence be available to me. With my wisdom and knowledge, I don't know how to climb on the mountain. I don't know what are the troubles in the mountain. When the stones fall, I don't know how to handle them. But if your presence accompanies me, I can cross over this mountain. And so he made an offering. He brought few stones, made an altar, worshiped God. My dear friends, mountain is symbolizing the presence. In our lives also, in our journey, many things we do not know what to do. We don't know how to handle in our lives. Sometimes we do not know what is going to happen in the future. What is ahead of us, we don't know. But in life, we need not to know also. All that we know is, need to know is, have the presence of God. In life, we may not get all that we want. In life, we may not know what is lying ahead of us. But carry the presence of God. And the presence of God will take you through all those experiences, all those mountains. When Abraham built an altar, God's power came upon Abraham. With that power, he, his wife, his cattle, his servants, everybody crossed and they went to other side. In your life also, whenever you kneel before the Lord and establish God's presence in your heart, in your lives, the power of the Lord will come upon you. This is true, 100% true. If you look at us, the Society of the Holy Spirit, we don't have schools, we don't have colleges. In our center, every day almost 50 to 60 people eat. We have got HIV children. We have mentally retarded people. We have brothers who are going to become priests. We have priests. How are we living? We don't know. God provides us. God supplies us. Whenever I need, all I have is my two knees. If you kneel before God, God will stand before you. And if God stands before you, you can face anyone. If God stands before you, nobody can stand against you. You will face life. We think we need many things in the world, but what need the most needed one is the presence of God. You have the presence of God, and your life will be a miracle. I'm telling you, as a priest of the Lord, I never lack anything. We don't have school, we don't earn, but we have everything. Anything we need, God supplies to us. Yes, that is our experience. Now Abraham built an altar. He said, Lord, you be with me and bless me with your presence. He hungered for the presence of God. Your intimacy with your God will be your power. Life with prayer is life with power. Life without prayer, your life will be with your little experience, with your riches, with your beauty, with your education, with your qualification. But that will not suffice to fulfill all your need. There are many things in life which we don't understand. Why did God ask Abraham to build an altar? Abraham may not know. You know what happened? Now Abraham died. His son Isaac died. His son Jacob died. And in that generation, now the people of Israel were 400 years in slavery. And one day, a man who was born in the descendant of Abraham, called Moses, with his cattle, he went to the same place. That place was known as Mountain of God. He went unknowingly, going with his cattle. Suddenly he saw fire is burning. So many years ago, Abraham lit the fire. And when a helpless man, Moses, running away from the king, frightened man, doesn't know how to live life, God remembered Abraham. And when Moses came near that mountain, God spoke, I am the God of Abraham. Moses got surprised. He saw the fire is burning. He went to close. It is not that fire. The tree is as it is. The presence of God. God spoke to Moses, my son, if you receive my presence, you will become my gift. Without my presence, life becomes a burden for you. With my presence, life becomes a mission for you. Now, can you go and deliver my people? Moses says, I am a frightened fellow. I am frightened of the king. Now you are asking me to go to the king. With your experience, you get frightened in life. But when you possess the presence of God, you will face the very thing that was frightening you once upon a time. You will not only face the things, face the people, and you will bring life out of them. Now God sent Moses and brought the people of Israel. Place your hands over your heart. God who spoke to Abraham, God who spoke to Moses, he speaks to you today. In life, we do not know many things, but his presence will lead you. With the presence of God on the mountain, today, what are the things you are not able to climb? Claim victory. claim in Jesus' name, Lord, you gave the power to Abraham, and you are the same yesterday, today, and forever. That's what your word says. Today, these are the problems which I am not able to overcome, which I am not able to claim. But I claim today now, with your power, I move on, Lord. Psalm 18, verse 28 says, Lord, you lit my candle, you lit my lamp, and you brighten my darkness, and with your power, I leap over all the obstacles. With your power, I cross over every obstacle. As you live